And it's Friday, and this time we got a long weekend ahead of us. So I know a lot of y'all are really excited, ready to hop off into this holiday weekend. If y'all are, if y'all got Monday off, send me a wave or a yes, I'm off on Monday. Tell me what's going on in your world. I'm already off on Monday, so y'all know that means nothing to me. But I am off on Tuesday, so I'm really excited. I get an extra day to relax and do nothing, really, because I don't have any plans. Anybody got any plans for their Labor Day weekend that I can live vicariously through? Anybody throwing any barbecues y'all want to invite me to? Anything like that? Hey, Nikki, Mia, Relinda, Jocelyn, how y'all doing out there? So I was just giving people a little minute to get on here. If you're on here and if you're on here now, I'm going to ask you to share this, if you would, if you could, because I just want to share this message with more people. So I'm going to do the same. So give me just a minute to do that. And then I'm going to hop right into what I want to talk about. We're going to have some fun today. I think we have fun every day, every time I'm on here, but we're really going to have some fun today. Why is this doing that? I don't know why I can't share it to my timeline. Anyway, I'm not going to worry about it. Y'all share it, I'll share it later. And, okay. So, today we are going to talk about working day and night. Woo! Okay, so y'all know 2 days ago it was Michael Jackson's birthday. Rest in peace to the King of Pop. Y'all know I love Michael Jackson, first of all. I'm not going to be able to like go on without telling y'all how much I love Michael Jackson. Like, I think I just love the Jackson family. And like my three favorite artists are Michael, Prince, and Janet. And Prince ain't a part of that family, but that's all right. I love him like he is my family. And like two of my favorite icons are gone. So I'm pouring all my love into Janet right now. But happy birthday to Michael Jackson. And I started this live with working day and night because it's Labor Day weekend. And, you know, on Labor Day we are, I guess, giving ourselves a rest or celebrating work or whatever you might want to say. And I had something completely different that I wanted to talk about, and I had started writing notes about because I said I was going to start doing that on Wednesdays so that on Fridays, you know, I can kind of rest and glide into what I'm going to talk about. But this morning, as I got to going, I left and I got in my car to go to work, and I had a completely different train of thought. So I was like, you know what? Let me let God run this thing. So as we talk about work, it's something that we don't all like to talk about. We don't all like to do. But I want to ask y'all a couple questions and feedback with me in the comments, if you would. What are you working for? That might take some thought. You might have to like think about, what am I really working for? But what are you working for? Who are you working for? And what is your why? Those are my three questions for the day that I want y'all to really like think about, especially if you're taking notes or you're a journaler like my good friend Nikki on here. What are you working for? Who are you working for? And what is your why? So the song says, you got me working day and night, and I'll be working sun up to midnight. Now that's a whole lot of work. And a lot of us, we work just as hard. I come from a very hardworking family. So all I've been taught to do my whole life is work and to take pride in my work. And I think that that's why I throw my all into what I do on a daily basis. I leave nothing on the table. Like, I just give it. And I enjoy it. I get pleasure out of the work that I do now. It hasn't always been that way. Y'all have heard me talk about it, so we don't even have to go there. But as I look over like my bloodline and my family, I think about like my grandmother, who y'all will learn is my favorite person in heaven and in earth next to Jesus. But my grandmother, she was a Rosie the Riveter. Have y'all ever heard of that, Rosie the Riveter? You know, the ladies who, while the men were off to war in World War II, they went to work in the factories to like build the bombs and build the artillery and the machinery and all of that. So she left Mississippi in the 40s during World War II. And she went to Indiana, where ultimately I was born. My mother was born. Her brother was born. And she went there to work. She had children in Mississippi that she needed to take care of. And so she actually left her children in Mississippi. She moved to Indiana because her cousin, you know, told her, girl, there's some work up here. You need to come up here and, you know, get this money. And so she left and she went up there. And for the rest of her life, she was just a hard worker. That's just who my grandmother was, whether it was cooking, cleaning, you know, just doing whatever she needed to do to take care of her family. She did it. And so I watched that. That was a model for me. My grandfather, he was an over-the-road big truck driver, so he was always on the road, always doing something, always working. He actually dropped out in third grade so that he could take care of his family or help take care of his family, and he worked until he couldn't work anymore. My grandfather died on the road, literally. He had a heart attack and ran off the road, so he worked himself until he couldn't. My mother has been working since she was, I think, 14 years old. She'll tell the stories about all these jobs that she's had. And I mean, she just works all the time. Like, all I know about my mother is work, work, work. I remember growing up and being at home. I was a latchkey kid. I was the only child. So I was at home a lot by myself because my mother was working. She was working to take care of me. And my dad, he will tell you to this day, he has worked the same job. He's been at the same company since 1974. Most of us on here probably wasn't even alive in 1974. But to this day, he still works for that same company, and he takes pride in the fact that he has never had to fill out an application, and he don't know what a resume looks like, because from the time he, 2 weeks after he graduated high school, until now, he is still at that company. Every time I talk to him, the first thing he asks me about is my job. That's all he wants to ask me. It's annoying, to be honest. But he takes such pride in work that's just his thing. And so I come from a hardworking family, but my family worked hard because they had to, not because they wanted to. None of us had a silver spoon in our mouth, you know. I have to work, bills, obligations, and everything, you know, that type of stuff. It'll keep you trapped if you don't formulate a plan to free yourself, which is part of the reason why I take pride in entrepreneurship, is because I look back and I watch the times that my mother sacrificed with me, and the times that her mother sacrificed, you know, to work and not really be able to focus or pour into their children the way that they may have wanted to because they had to work. So when I started off and I asked you, what are you working for? Thank you, Mia, for answering. She says she's working for financial freedom. She works for herself, and her why is her kids. And my whys and my answers are something similar. I'm going to tell you what mine are. I'm working for financial freedom and to exercise my gifts. I consider my work an act of worship. I feel like what I do and what I'm called to do on a daily basis, I'm exercising the gifts that God gave me, and I'm showing forth his glory. So that's where I get my gratitude, my gratification for the work that I do from. Who am I working for? First of all, I'm working for God. And second of all, I'm working for me, of course. And my why is my future children and grandchildren. And recompense for my great-grandparents and my grandparents and my parents. I feel like they all worked so hard and they tried to get ahead and they tried to build something. So I owe it to them to work just as hard so that I can secure something for the people ahead of me or behind me, rather. I don't have no children. I don't know whether I will ever have children or grandchildren. I pray that someday I do. But I work with them in mind. I work and I save and I invest with them in mind because I want to be able to spend time with them and pour into them and invest in them more than just showing them how to work. And I want to be able to give them me. And I want to be able to give them something. I see people, you know, somebody just told me about a 36-year-old that I guess his uncle died or something and left him like $50 million. And I'm saying, dang, this dude is my age and his uncle left him this money. Like, I want to be that person in my family that even if I don't have a kid, that my nephews, Drew and Trey, they might be able to say, you know, my auntie thought enough of me and she left me $50 million apiece. Like, I want to be that person. I want to have that generational wealth building and growing, and I want to leave a legacy, whether it's with my children or not, whether I'm blessed to have them or not. So, you know that my, I'm always going to go with a scripture verse, and I got a couple that I want to share with y'all today, but the first one I want to go to is Colossians 3:23. Turn with me in your Bibles, if you will. No, I'm just kidding. I'm going to read it for you. I just feel like I should say that. Turn with me in your Bibles, if you will. So Colossians 3:23 says, work willingly at whatever you do, as though you were working for the Lord rather than for people. Y'all, this week, I had to lean in on that verse. I had to, like, really focus myself in on that verse. Because we go to work sometimes and we get so caught up in what's happening at work or what the people around us may or may not be doing or whatever the case. Or we just tired and burned out and we just want to go home and lay down. Like, it was so many days this week, I just was like, I just want to take a nap. I just want to lay down. I don't want to be here. And y'all know I love what I do. I was just tired and I was just wanting to do something else. Other than be at work, be at my desk. But I had to think, you know, my work, like I said, it's an act of worship. And I'm not created to toil. I don't think any of us are created to toil for anyone or anything. But sometimes we allow ourselves to become workaholics. We don't have that harmony that we should have in our lives. And we pour ourselves so much into what we do that we allow it to affect us positively or negatively. So toil. I really want to kind of go there because I'm gonna be honest. My mama might get mad at me if she watches this, but I don't care. My mother, I already told y'all how hard she works, but I have watched her my whole life toil. I mean, when I say toil, I mean, I don't know a harder working woman than my mother, to the point that last year, her job forced her to retire. And it really broke my heart to see, because I always have been like, Lord, what is my mama going to do if she don't have work to do? Like, what is that going to look like? Is she going to have a breakdown? Am I going to have to like watch her? Because that's just how much she works. And even after she stopped working, she like went and found another job. She's still looking for work. Like, she just cannot sit still. And I'm always trying to admonish her about investing in herself rather than toiling and toiling and toiling for other people and other things. So toil, what is that? It means work extremely hard or incessantly, exhausting physical labor and struggle. If that's you, if you are in that place, let me encourage you to make a shift somewhere in what you're doing, because that is not what God has called you to do at all. Yes, he called you to work, because the man that don't work does not eat, but he never called you to toil. I always say on here, you know, he didn't ask you to give your all to everybody and everything, but he wants you to work as though you're working unto him. My other scripture verse that I want to share, if I can pull it up, is Psalm 127 and 2. And it goes into what I'm talking about as far as toil. And it says, it is useless for you to work so hard from early morning until late at night, anxiously working for food to eat, for God gives rest to his loved ones. That sat with me too. That I had to like really think about that, because I've told y'all, you know, I worked myself so hard in the beginning of me starting this business. And I have friends who are in business now who I see that, I mean, they're giving it their all, and I commend them. I know that it takes hard work to build anything by yourself. But as this says, it's useless for you to work so hard from early morning until late at night. If you're not getting proper rest, if you're not able to invest time in your family and friends, if you can't just have a moment of peace without you always thinking about what's your next move and what you're going to do in your business next, when do you have time to just sit and reflect, meditate, pray, and really hear from God what your next move should be? Because all that extra motion that you're doing, it could be stopped if you just took the time to sit still for a moment. He can give you a revelation that says go here, and you could get something done in an hour that it would have taken you in your own strength 2-3 days to do. So I want to encourage y'all, like, don't, when you're taking this 3-day weekend, I pray that y'all get a three-day weekend or a 4-day weekend, whatever it is. I'm off, like I said, on Tuesday. That you take the time to really enjoy yourself and rest and kick your feet up and like turn it off, turn off the work, turn off the emails and the text messages and whatever else have your attention and are distracting you from your greater purpose. Because even though work is a part of your purpose, it is not your ultimate purpose. You work your purpose out, but at the same time, God commands us to rest. He commands us to rest. So, like I was saying, this week I was tempted to be discouraged. I felt like I had given, and I was like changing gears so much, doing so many different things. And I really, I thank God, because on Wednesday, Pastor Brady came in and she spoke to our servant leaders and our team leads, which I'm a team lead. But she was saying that if you forget or you lose sight of your why and what you, the why and what you do, that you will be depleted. You'll be twice depleted, actually, she said. She said, because you'll be depleted because you're working so hard, but you'll also be depleted because you won't get the gratification of knowing what your why was and knowing that you walked it out and you worked it out. So when I said that my why or who I'm working for is for God, even though, yes, I work at a church, so technically everything that I do there is for God. And everything that I do, even in my business, is for him. And I have to keep that in front of mind, because I know that nothing that I do for him is in vain. And so I want to encourage y'all today to take that same mindset, that you're not working for AT&T or you're not working for Blue Cross Blue Shield or whatever other companies you may work for. I'm just throwing stuff out there. I don't know where y'all work. But you're not working for them. You're working for God. You're working for your legacy. You're working for your future. So that's really all I had to share with y'all today. Today was kind of short, sweet, and to the point. But stay encouraged in what you do for your vocation. And enjoy y'all's weekend. Now, before I go, I got a brief commercial, as I always do. The Fear Not Workshop. It doesn't start this Monday because that's a holiday and I'm resting. But it starts the following Monday, September 10th. It starts at 7 o'clock p.m. If you are interested in this workshop, I'm typing. Okay, it's in the comments. It's fearnotworkshop.eventbrite.com. I'm looking forward to really sharing and digging in with a group of ladies in this intimate setting where we're able to encourage one another, put plans together, and really push each other in our purpose, in our goals, and watch some of these things manifest and come to life. So if that's you, and you know that it's something that you're sitting on, or it's something that you've been procrastinating with and you need to finish it, or you need some accountability, click that link. Today is the day. Sign up, get in the class, get in the group, and we're gonna make this thing happen. All right? All right, y'all, it's been Friday at 4, and I'll see y'all next week. Enjoy your weekend. Love y'all.